are here with Losers Finals of PCH, Tapu, and of course, none other than Empress against Matt Q. Okay, does the job and catches the main Ice Climber with the Thunder. Also, from what I just heard, Wander has cracked. That shield dangerously low. And did I just see Nana fly? Just floated. Okay, a lot of people working. I should have been like, let me take some of those places if they not so well. Currently, oh, that almost was it. Imagine if those hammers were DDD hype. Oh, misses the forward smash, gets knocked by the forward tilt. Spot dodge the first one, you always got the second one to worry about. Okay. And then it's dead, and so it's open. That brings us to the last stock to pop. Of course, Tasku, PCO from Empress looking for the run back against Shelter, Yami, and crew. Shelter, Gyarados, and Yami. Let me put some respect on Gyarados' name. Alright, 59-35 at the moment. Again, I said it earlier, I would like to see more grabs come out from G-Funk. Especially with the especially with Ice Climbers. Works it out with the up throw. And off the jump with the with the forward tilt, that's gonna be game. So PCH against G-Funky. Let me switch sides. Fell to PCH. Versus Pichu. Dark Deathmash coming in with a fresh set of stocks while Pichu owns his last stock from last game. Go! Again, playing Ice Climbers is like fighting against Mega Kangaskhan in Pokemon X and Y. For those who remember the Mega Evolution days. Whenever you think you got one, you'll forget about the other. Well, the other comes out. 34% already. Part of that being self-inflicted damage, I'm surprised that it did not connect. Seemed like Robin was just right there to get hit by the Thunder. So 90% healed himself with the Nosferatu. course, that makes you more liable and susceptible to combos, especially from Pichu. So 99% to 46. Now to see if Dr. Deathmatch goes for another one, but the gentleman's job not going to take it, surprisingly. Oh, and actually gets hit by the impact of Arc Thrust.
The key to victory lies with
him. All I hear is PCH so upset that that hit him. It's the second time that PCH has ended up on the wrong side of history on stream. The impact of Arc Thunder and the explosive hitbox it has ended up taking him out as he tried to land on top of Dark Deathmatch. Unfortunate, but you know that's how the move works. Alright, so with that, we are going to more than likely get Empress versus Dark Deathmatch. That's that we've also seen quite a few times here at NIU. And to be expected, we're going to see how Empress plays around those projectiles of Game & Watch. Good job at recovery. Thought he was dead to rights for a second, and then ended up using the... Oh my god! Why did he go so deep? And made it back. That would have been mighty unfortunate if he, you know, if he were to... Oh! And that's why we text. Oh, he's taunting! Oh, nah! The disrespect.
Arc fire.
How could you, man? So right now, 46%. 46% as Empress starts her second stock. And right now, Dark Deathmatch doesn't have that, doesn't have the level sword until now. Guys out of the air dodges. Well, back air, excuse me. Not gonna connect. Good shield. Oh, get up attack to avoid getting buried, or at least knocked back. Down. And again, that arc fire has such crazy range. And again, the get up attack. And what is close to 130 to 63 at the moment. Surprise, Empress didn't go for the forward tilt. And right now, it's 144-63. Staying alive. Dash attack's going to take it at ledge. And Empress trying to close this one out. Go into G-Funky with a decent amount of stocks. 30%. Well, 20% is how much damage that dealt. But even still, very good job. So currently 65.5% to 56.7%. And actually absorbs the arc fire straight up. 67, trying to get a kill here. Forward air not going to take it from center stage, but did quite a bit of knockback. And again, that upbeat is one of Game & Watch's best options. Could have ended up getting hit by a forward smash if they weren't careful. And Gentleman's Jab is going to kill at play. Again, fire is a lot stronger than expected. Ended up, got jab locked into the forward smash, and that's going to do it for Dark Adept Match. Or, as his name unfortunately spells out, Damn. Not damn as in the curse word, but damn as in a reservoir that contains water. Yes, I had to clarify. I'm not trying to get Lisa Freeman to take away my degree. Again, running joke we have. Against Shelter, catching them a couple of times off stage, and it almost led to something special, something cool, but the up tilt into the back here is what excuse me. So right now, 30% to 17. Mewmon, of course, going to go into this looking to maintain all three of his stocks. But Game & Watch has plenty of tools that can take out Greninja relatively early. And of course, given Game & Watch's, well, likeness, that's also the case for Greninja. I think a down tilt into up smash might take it at this point. Oh, good tech. That was almost a funky interaction. But, well, it was a funky interaction, but it almost ended up being worse. 172, 90%. And caught him mashing. Not gonna take him out. Good job on the DI from Mewmon to survive that. Dash attack. But Nair off the top, also not going to take it. Greninja living at 171. But down smash is gonna kill across the stage. It's like a Greninja player I know once said, Greninja either dies at 40 or lives to 140. There is no in between. And clearly we saw that, well, come to fruition. Going for the forward smash, the shield, 54, 105. Oh, he uses the dash attack to get away from this substitution counter. That actually could have ended up being the stock right there, taking out Empress. Goes for the up smash, not gonna get it. 92. Oh, good spot dodge. Excellent reaction time from Empress to avoid that counter. Goes for the up smash, not gonna get it. If it was Mario's up smash, then probably gets the good. Recovers. And down air, not gonna take it. Goes deep for it. Oh, gets the berry on the other side, and right now, Empress living on one stock and gets forward tilted. But Empress did her job. Maintained that one stock for as long as she could. Ends up taking Mewmon down to his last. Now allowing Tasbu to wrap it up with hopefully relative ease. I'm back, and I just witnessed Mewmon take the first stock from Tasbu. Again, wondering why Tasbu chose to go Bowser instead of Min Min in this instance. I tried to get the fire breath going for the up smash. Oh! And misses the forward smash. How unfortunate, but catches the jump with yet another forward air. Yumon at 70. That's who on his last stop.
Why did that hit? That should not have hit.